We come to you from Death Valley, where crowds have once registered as an earth tremor at the school's geology department.
And it's a little cloudy out here tonight for this game between
the Tigers and the Buckeyes.
Hi, everybody. This is Brad Nessler with Kirk Herbstreit, Lee Corso, and Aaron Andrews. It's time for some college football action.
And we're set to bring you another great matchup in the world of NCAA football.
Ohio State is led today by their star player at quarterback. This kid is one of the most exciting players in college football due to his speed and running ability out of the backfield. It's not often you'll find an athlete of his caliber at quarterback, so watch out for him to make some big plays with both his arm and his feet today.
So the pregame routine's over, and we're ready for the coin toss.
We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. Across midfield, at the 40. Got an opening. To the 20. To the 10. He'll take it all the way for the touchdown. Guys, what do you think about that one?
I'll tell you what. This kid is a real playmaker.
You know what, Lee? Sheer determination displayed right there. He set his sights in the end zone and would not be denied.
And he converts the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off. Across midfield, at the 40, inside the 30. Here he goes. He returns it all the way to score. As you guys mentioned, his speed is the difference here.
Yep, once he hit that opening, he was gone. Beautiful blocking on that play also.
We'll be tied with the extra point. He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Short kickoff. He gets out to about the 45-yard line.
So let's see how the defense will hold up now as this offense comes out for their next drive.
One man backfield. Run the middle and nothing there. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
And it's the senior linebacker who came up with the stop.
He's always on top of the run. Not much room for the ball carrier to work on that play.
And they motion a guy to the left. Slings it. To the 20. To the 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown. The wideout makes a big catch there.
Hey, whenever you have a receiver who can make plays like that, you just want to get the ball in his hands and let him do the work.
Listen up, my friend. That was a tremendous throw by the quarterback, too. Don't forget about the guy slinging the ball all over the field out there.
And he adds the extra point. And now we take a look at the drive summary. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He sends it off. He's to the 20. At the 40. Across midfield. Inside the 30. Big opening. Touchdown, Tigers. And I think you can see by now why many people call him one of the most exciting players in college football.
And that's twice now this guy has taken it to the house. Coach, I don't know if they could stop this guy if they put trenches in the field.
The only way they could stop him if they just stopped kicking him the football. This kid is miraculous.
LSU, ready to kick this one off. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. He's out to the 30. At the point.
Oh, so close to breaking it. A touchdown was the end result of their last drive as this offense moved the ball very well with their passing game.
They really beat them up with that passing attack.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
They line up with one running back in the backfield, three wide.
They'll throw on first down. And open touchdown.
And they had a tough time defending that one.
Well, Brad, one of the things with this defense is you leave yourself vulnerable in one-on-one coverage. Great throw by the quarterback and great speed by the receiver.
That was a really nice throw by the quarterback. He found the receiver in between the coverage on the post route, and he had no problem finding the end zone.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Here's the drive summary to recap what just happened. They line up to kick this one away. Decent kick. Gets to about the 41-yard line. And now we'll see the offense come out onto the field for their next possession. The defense sets up in the nickel. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
They sure did, but somehow he got rid of the football.
Ace backfield. Man in motion. And he carries the ball for a nice game. They'll get 6 yards.
Six on the play.
They come out with four wide out. Wide out makes the first down catch. And Herbie, that was a good-looking throw.
Yeah, and what impresses me is the composure of this young quarterback. He made a great read, saw the open receiver, and delivered an almost perfect strike. Good-looking play.
The offense lines this one up in the shotgun. Three wide receivers in the formation. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideout. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
Again with the run. They'll bring him down around the 32-yard line. He picked up big yardage on that run.
Oh, this is great blocking up front. Nice job of holding on to their blocks, allowing him to break through for some big yards.
Not much room there as they hand it off straight up the middle. They couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage on that one.
Well, I don't think they did a very good job of selling the pass. The defense was able to read the play and come right in there and make a nice stop.
Here's the halfback. Decent run here, right side. I'm not sure what happened, but one of the players is hurt. The backfield's in an offset eye formation. They tackle him there, and he's still going to be short. They'll still be short of the first down.
They didn't have far to go, Brad, but it didn't matter because this defense was ready for them.
And now it's fourth down, Coach.
Now let's go down to our sideline reporter, Erin Andrews. She's got an injury update.
Thanks, guys. I talked to the trainers, and the good news is that it appears to be only an abdominal strain and not a tear of the abdominal muscle. They've sent him back to the locker room, and I've been told he is done for the game. Guys?
Well, these guys are going to have to find somebody else to step up now. Thanks, Erin. Single set back for you. To the wide out, and he can't pull it in. Second and 10, ball on the 24-yard line. Single back set, three wide receivers. And they get nice yardage on that run. A gain of about 4 yards on the draw. The quarterback's in the gun with three receivers in the set. There's a handoff, and he's brought down right away.
They were not going to let them close to the marker. Big play on third down.
That's just what they needed, a strong stop to get some momentum back on their side.
Signals for a fair catch. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. Man in motion. Drops back on first down. He ignores the footsteps and makes the catch. They just couldn't get to the quarterback in time.
That's one of the things that can happen if a defense brings extra guys to rush the quarterback. The offense will have favorable matchups to get the ball downfield.
And this kid is talented enough to see those receivers. It's not easy to get the ball past those big bulldozers when they're flying right at you.
Ace backfield. Toss play. Tackle at the 38-yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run.
Not much for the ball carrier there.
Yeah, Coach, the safety came up from the secondary and made a nice, solid tackle.
Throws it out, and it falls incomplete. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. He throws it. Incomplete. It's knocked down by the defense. Defense really came up with a big stop right there.
Yeah, that's a tough one to swallow. Great play by the defense.
They line up in an eye. Not much room there as they hand it off straight up the middle. And the halfback's got nowhere to go. High formation here. Throws complete and he stopped immediately. Nice pass there, and the quarterback was under a lot of pressure from the defense.
And that one will move them a little closer to the sticks. Nice 6-yard gain.
Hit as he throws. That'll bring up fourth down.
Fourth down, and let me say one thing. This defense was up to the task that time in shutting down the pass play.
Yeah, they shut it down, and they got the three and out they were looking for.
And now a slight break in the action as the offense comes out onto the field for their next possession. There are three wide receivers split out. Quarterback's in the pistol. Feeds it to the back. Tackled after a decent pickup. The misdirection play gets him 4 yards. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. Our score here at Tiger Stadium, the Buckeyes 21, the Tigers 14. They line up with one running back in the backfield. Three wide. They go with a run. He's at midfield. Down the sideline. And he's finally shoved out at the 4-yard line. A spectacular run.
You know, usually when the defense is all over the place, that's a good thing. In this case, it's a bad thing.
Well, let me tell you something, Lee. There was a lot of running room there. This defense may have nightmares tonight about this running back running all over them.
For the first time today, we'll get to see how this defense responds when they're backed up into the red zone. He drops back. He's in trouble. They bring the quarterback down.
As a quarterback, you have to be aware of the pass rush.
Formation here. Throws complete, touchdown. The big fella made a heck of a catch there.
Hey, he's blocking. Then the defense forgets about him and whoop, he puts points on the scoreboard.
We'll be tied with the extra point. Converts the extra point. So we take a moment here. Let's check out the drive summary. LSU to kick this one off. And this one's a short kick. Looking for the corner at the 40. Inside the 30. The 10. He's all the way.
Touchdown. And that one is going to make the highlight reels, folks.
Yo, is this kid sensational or what, my friend?
And he hits the PAT. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends it off. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 39-yard line. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
And this defense needs to fill those holes. Otherwise, this offense will march it right down into the end zone again.
The defense looked a little lost on that one, Kirk.
Yeah, they did, Brad. Nice recognition here by the quarterback to see that confusion and then take advantage of it.
Straight run, nothing going on there. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3.
Yeah, not too much on that run.
With these linebackers sitting back waiting for plays like that, it'll be very hard for this offense to pick up yards on the ground.
Takes it right, and he can't get back to the line. Well, the defense really put the clamps down on that run.
Boy, Greg, great effort up front by that defense.
Complete, brought down, nothing doing. That play was designed to pick up a first down, but they didn't do it.
It looks like the receiver just lost track of where he was on the field.
These guys will give them that rinky-dinky play all day long. You need more than that if you're going to get a first down on these guys.
You know what drives me crazy?
What's that, Kirk?
When players don't look for the ball on special teams. Too often, the gunners don't locate the ball and let it go into the end zone. But this guy did a great job of getting downfield and downing the ball, giving his defense good field position.
That takes a little pressure off of him.
That's a big play. When you're practically taking the snap in your own end zone, it can easily cause an ill-advised pass if you get rushed. A good composure by this quarterback to pick up the first down.
Picked up a yard of anything on that run.
Not much at all there for the ball carrier.
Yep, he had a hole, but this senior linebacker closed that up in a hurry and made a really good tackle.
And the defense was ready for that play.
Boy, you better believe it. That play didn't have a chance.
It's absolutely deafening down there. He drops back, and they got him. And they get a nice defensive play.
And here's a play you don't see very often. That time they brought pressure from the corner position, and the line couldn't pick him up, and he was able to wrap the quarterback up for a sack. That's a good defensive call.
This junior cornerback has so much speed coming off the edge. If you don't see him early, woo, trouble for the quarterback.
There's a player injured, but it looks like it's just a stinger. They'll go to work at the 30-yard line. One man backfield. Man in motion. And they make the stop at the 12-yard line. And a pretty smart call right there.
You're absolutely right. The reason why this play worked is that the play action froze the defense just enough to allow the receiver to get open.
With an injury update, here's Aaron Andrews.
Thanks, Brad. His shoulder is a little strained, and the trainers are applying treatment. He appears ready to return to the game. Back up to you, Brad.
Sounds like good news then. Thanks, Aaron. They give to the tailback. Tackle after decent pickup. 7 yards there. It's third down. Here they go, only 2 yards from Pater. They come out with a big set. He's in. Touchdown. Well, that's how you get it done when you're down by the goal line, Coach.
When you're close like this, you tell your guys, get in there, push, shove, and block. Just get the ball in the end zone.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he adds the extra point. That score leads us to our drive somewhere. LSU ready to kick this one off. And it's a short kickoff. The 50. At the 40. Inside the 30.
the 10. And a huge touchdown play.
I'd say he opened a few eyes with that return, Lee.
He may open some eyes, but he shut some mouths on the other team with that little scamper.
And he tacks on the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
Clipping on the receiving team.
So clipping on the play will send the offense backwards.
You're always taught that if you can see a player's name on his jersey, don't block him.
Hey, apparently he didn't see it. And another thing he might not see is more playing time.
Pulls it in, but he can't stay in bounds, and that'll be a loss. From their own 17-yard line, second down. Two tight ends here. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. The defense calls a timeout. Nickel defense. He drops back. Makes the first down catch.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
And they bring him down at the 40. The offense calls a timeout. They come out with four wide out. First down, looking to throw.
That's what a good pass rush can do for you.
Yeah, they got in the quarterback's face and made it tough on him to throw a good pass.
They're in the shotgun with three wide receivers. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
This linebacker wasn't letting this guy go anywhere. Very nice tackle.
And it looks like they're going to go no huddle here. Their last trip down here was a success. Let's see if this one will result in another touchdown. Passes to the wide out, and he can't pull it in. So it's second and 10. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. High formation here. Takes it right and brought down right away. The running back gets two on the carry. And the blitz works that time.
And let me say this. Now pay attention. This is exactly why you want to put the pressure on a quarterback. That time it was an incomplete pass. The next time it may be an interception.
And here's our drive summary. LSU lines up for the kickoff. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. And now we'll see the offense come out of the field for their next possession. The quarterback's in the gun with three receivers in the set. Drops back on first down. Takes the grab past the marker. The offense calls a timeout. Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. Drops back to pass. Under heavy pressure. And that one's incomplete. A great first half comes to a close. Our score here in Death Valley, the Buckeyes, 35, the Tigers, 31.
35, LSU, 31.
Ohio State will be kicking off to start the second half. He kicks it off. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. So let's see how the defense will hold up now as this offense comes out for their next drive. First and 10. Ball on the 41. There are four wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Catches it, and he's punished. About 5 yards that time on the throw.
Not a bad play. They gain 5 yards out of it, and they keep moving the defense back.
Three wideouts here. Not much room there as they hand it off straight up the middle. And the halfback's got nowhere to go. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. From the gun. On the ground with the tailback. Runs right for a nice gain. And it looks like he got the first down.
I'll tell you what, Brad, that is very close. I didn't think he was going to make it there, Coach.
Kirk, I agree with you 100%. I thought he would stop short, too. This kid shows some real determination on that run.
He didn't really have a chance on that play.
Boy, guys, how about the defense on this play? They sniffed that play out from the start.
They motion to the right. Takes a handoff inside and stopped immediately. And he manages to get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. They come out in an empty backfield. He's looking to pass. And he's got the junior. Well, he caught it, but it's almost no yards gain, and now it's fourth down.
Give props to the D here for coming up with a big stop on third down.
Yeah, there's no way that short stuff is going to work on these guys. Great play to bring up fourth down.
Catches it, and they've got it. He really didn't have any room to work on that punt return.
Yeah, but his blockers have to do a better job of helping him out. They didn't hold the coverage team at bay. They just let him right through.
Nice pitch and catch for the first down. And they tackle him at the 44-yard line. And that play could have gone for six.
Oh, boy, you're right. And all week long, this secondary did a lot of talking about how they were going to dominate these receivers. I think this is time that they step up and prove it on the field. Forget about talking trash. Let's see how they react after giving up that big play.
Catches it. He's at midfield. Very good tackle in space. And a good call that time.
Yeah, and in my opinion, it's plays like this that can have a lot of success against this defense.
He lets it go. And they couldn't hook up on that one. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
Up the middle for a nice gain. It's first and 10, ball on the 41-yard line. Single back set, three wide receivers. They'll throw on first down. Here's the tight end, drops. From the 41-yard line, it's second down. Ohio State is up four. Throws. And he's tackled at the 16-yard line. They complete the long pass that time.
And remember what we talked about. It's extremely important for this defense to stop them here after giving up that big play. This is very important. You don't want that water leak to turn into a flood.
No, you don't.
And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
You can't stay in the pocket all day long like that. The defense is going to get there eventually.
Nickel defense. They'll keep it on the ground again. Decent run here, right side. And we'll take a break while the injured player is attended to. So we're looking at another third down here. And this crowd is going crazy. Hands it to the back. He's taken down at the 10. They tried to run the ball for the first down. They didn't get it.
No, sir. You saw the defense just power through their blocks and wham into them.
And it sails through the uprights. And now we're going to take a look at the drive summary. Ohio State ready to kick this one off. He sends it off. Makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. And we have an update on an injury. Aaron?
Thank you, Brad. They're calling it a grade 2 abdominal strain, which will limit his mobility and may affect his ability to change direction quickly. The injury looks to be pretty serious, and right now they're saying he will be out of action for a while. Guys?
Thanks, Aaron. They're going to have to find someone to step into that role for a while. I wonder who that will be. And he's tackled at the 24-yard line. He caught some key blocks and was able to turn it into a 10-yard gain. The defense lines up with five defensive backs. Passes it to the middle of the field. Brought down at the 14. Nice little pitch and catch with a wideout.
The quarterback and receiver spend a lot of time together. The coaches say they stay after practice, just working on their timing, and right there it paid off.
They'll run it. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play.
This kid is something special. You got to have a certain kind of mentality to play the linebacker position.
And is that ever true, Coach? If you want to be the best linebacker, you have to be able to do it all. Cover the receivers, bring down the running backs, take on blocks, rush the quarterback, and sometimes call the plays for the defense. It's all about chipping away at the defense. Even short yardage completions can have a way of building a quarterback's confidence.
Yep. You never know when these guys can break some tackles and turn a small play into a big one.
A great game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. Our score here in Baton Rouge, Ohio State 38, LSU 31. He's got it out to his tight end, and they make the stop at the 3-yard line. Wonderful play call to convert on third down.
I'll tell you what, he really wanted that first down. Good determination again.
Touchdown. And guys, what do you think of that touchdown run?
Well, I really like the way the line made room for this guy to run through.
I like the way he used his vision there to run through the hole. This offense is really clicking right now.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. And now we take a look at the drive summary. They line up to kick this one away. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. Guys, what do you think about this situation?
This is a critical position on both sides of the ball. And I know this team wants the lead back.
And these players on defense are not going to make it easy, Coach. They are fired up. They don't want to give the lead away again.
He goes up and gets it.
Man, Lee, that looked familiar, didn't it? It looks like one of the plays I make against you on the EA video game, wasn't it, Coach?
Not so fast, my friend. I've been practicing, and I'm ready for another go.
Tackle right around the 28-yard line. He got what he could, and it wasn't much. It's second down and 9 to go. Ball on the 28-yard line. Two tight ends set. He just took a licking. Picked up big yards there, and he's going to have a first down.
Yeah, nice job there. This guy does a good job in reading his blocks and accelerating through the holes.
Slings it out there incomplete.
You got to keep it under control. That's some nice arm strength, but it doesn't matter if it's not on target.
You're absolutely right, Coach. You have to be accurate on those type of passes.
They almost got to him that time.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
And that sets them up with a first and goal.
Oh, man, they had him good there. The defense was looking run, and they threw it for a big game.
The running back really sold the run well that time. That allowed for the quarterback to get the ball downfield for a decent game.
All the big boys are on the field now. Both teams have their big sets out there. It's a fumble. It's scooped up by the offense. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
Gain of two on the
from the 1-yard line. Second down. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Quick strike, and he drops it.
Wow, that was close to being a touchdown.
Very close. The defender, though, did a great job of making sure that he didn't come away with the ball.
They'll try the fullback, and he plows in for the touchdown. What do you think of this guy, Lee?
This guy's a giant tailback playing fullback. He's got all the moves a halfback has, and he's got the power of a fullback. What a great combo.
I think everybody in the stadium knew that was going to be a run play, and the defense just couldn't stop it.
And he adds the extra point. Here's the drive summary to recap what just happened. Ohio State gets set to kick this one away. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. He's out to the 30. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. So what do you think about this situation, fellas?
Well, they have a little bit of time, but I think it's very crucial that they get the ball in the end zone on this possession.
I agree with you, Kirk. They can take their time, but a field goal is just about out of the question. What do you think of this back so far today, Kirk?
He's looked pretty good to me, Coach. He's been effective between the tackles, and he's shown his speed on some outside runs.
And he's been a huge part of this offensive game plan all day. Don't forget about that.
And they get nice yardage on that one. Pretty good gain on the play by the halfback.
Here the back does a good job of following his blocks and picking up 7 yards.
They hit it off again. There's a very impressive open field tackle. The back gets 3 on the carry.
Good play by the linebacker there.
One thing the coaches always say about this sophomore is that he has great lateral movement. That lets him move well behind this defensive line and get after a lot of plays in the running game.
Gain of 2 on the play.
4 wide. Drops back to pass. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. So there was not much doing on that pass play, and that's going to bring up 4th down.
And outside of an incompletion, that's the best thing this defense could ask for. A short pass and nowhere for the receiver to run.
Great concentration.
Look out. If you're one-on-one in man coverage, you can't let your man beat you to the inside on a post route. That'll be a new set of downs every time.
From the 25-yard line, first down. There are 4 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Caught, and he's hit immediately. 3 yards there on the play.
Nice catch there by the sophomore, but even better play by the defense to keep him from going nowhere after the play.
He'll get it again. Nice run there. So they go on the ground and pick up another first down.
Yo, nice run and good job to keep the chains moving.
They are stringing together a nice little drive here. If they keep this up, it'll be hard to keep them out of the end zone.
They hand it off again. Tackle outside after a nice pickup. The tailback picks up 6 there on the misdirection. EA Sports and Russell Athletic would like to congratulate today's players of the game. Nice job, guys. Run the middle and nothing there. That run picks up a yard, maybe less. One man backfield. Throws. Well, they're looking for another 4th down conversion. They've already gotten 1 this drive. Sacked, and they'll turn it over. They turn the ball over after going for it on 4th down.
Yeah, but they still made the right call. At this stage in the game, they'll try anything to get back in it.
A conversion there could have really helped them, but it just wasn't to be. First down, 10 to go. 2 tight end set. Here's a running play. Tackled after a decent pickup. The defense calls a timeout. They line up in an eye. They'll work the left. Good outside run there.
The defense calls a timeout.
From their own 25-yard line. First down.
Two tight ends here.
He'll keep it on the ground again.
Across midfield. Inside the 30. For the 10. Touchdown. Big play.
And that might be enough to do it here.
Yep. I think I hear the fat lady warming up her vocals.
I don't know. I think I hear someone speaking maybe a little bit too soon. Crazier things have happened in college football.
Point. Let's take a glance at the drive summary. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off. Oh, man. He took him down hard. Guys, what are you thinking at this point in the game?
Well, if you believe in miracles, then this game is not over yet. But I'll be honest with you. We've already sent Coach down to warm up the bus. Wait, what are you doing back here?
Hey, I do believe in miracles. I'm not going anywhere.
Gets it out to the wideout, and he's got the first.
He goes down at the 21. And they get away with one thrown into coverage.
Boy, the quarterback very fortunate there. But I'll tell you, watching them in practice this week, this is something that they felt pretty confident that they have some success with.
You're right, and the receivers are taught to play defense if they aren't in position to catch the football.
There's a strike complete, and he's down. And Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Great tackle by the senior to make sure this guy couldn't rumble for any extra yards.
Number 3, the intended receiver on the play.
The defense lines up with 6 DBs. Man in motion. He lets it go. Finds the tight end for a touchdown. The quarterback mixed things up a bit and found the big guy for the score.
This kid has worked very, very hard at his receiving skills, and I've seen a lot of improvement in him. And how about that? 4th and long, and they were able to convert for a touchdown. That was an incredible play.
And he tacks on the extra point. That score leads us to our drive summary. Here it goes. Take a hit. There's an injured player, and we'll try to find out who it is. First down, 10 yards to go. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. The defense calls a timeout. From the 38-yard line, 2nd down. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. And he'll just kneel it here. That's going to do it for this one. Our final score, Ohio State 52, LSU 45. As we take a look at the play of the game, Kirk, your final thoughts on this one.
Well, this one really could have gone either way. LSU had plenty of chances to win this football game, but it wasn't meant to be today. All you can do now is try to bounce back after a close loss like this.
Well, that does it for this presentation of NCAA Football 10. For Aaron, Kirk, and Lee, I'm Brad Nessler. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.